guys, we don't have a pulse. Can we get call code?
Imagine this is your child experiencing a medical emergency, and it's the first time a healthcare provider is responding to a situation like this. Thanks to innovative training and education at Johns Hopkins All Children's Hospital, our teams will be prepared to deliver the safest care.
Healthcare simulation is essentially a technique to train healthcare providers in high-risk, rare, or complex situations.
Continue CPR.
We can practice on mannequins and simulators, and particularly in pediatrics, it just makes all the sense in the world. No one wants a child to be the tool for learning for the first time. In our field, we're taking care of the most vulnerable, fragile patients. With this tool, I can train others to save thousands of lives.
From emergency situations to in-depth medical procedures, teams at Johns Hopkins All Children's use simulation to practice and perfect their skills.
Having that kind of practice helps me to feel more comfortable, to help me know that I can show more confidence being a nurse on the floor, because you want to make sure that families see that you have that confidence, that you know what you're doing and know when to ask for help.
Medical errors are the third leading cause of death in our country. And what we have also found is that the majority of medical errors are actually not caused by a lack of knowledge or skill on the part of providers, but it's typically a deficiency in communication, teamwork in a stressful situation that leads to errors happening.
With simulation training, I learned a lot. It's important that everyone is on the same page. When we work together as a team, we have a better outcome.
With philanthropy, we have the opportunity to continue to grow innovative training and education, taking simulations straight to families and the community.
Specifically, in our NICU setting, we're now training all the families who take home a baby who is on a ventilator. So we have babies who, because of prematurity or other issues with their lungs, have the need to be on mechanical ventilation. That's a child that's very vulnerable and very high risk at home. And unfortunately, while we train our parents at the bedside as much as possible, they'll never have the opportunity to practice a life-threatening emergency that could happen after they go home unless they were able to do it in simulation.
Soon, with the construction of our research and education building, philanthropic investments from our community, and the help of the right teams and technology, programs here will grow exponentially, embedding simulation into the fabric of our organization.
This space is state-of-the-art. It's the largest pediatric-focused simulation center in the state of Florida. It has mock-ups of every patient room, ORs, ERs, ICU rooms, even elevators, so that we can train and prepare our staff appropriately for what they need to do in the hospital. But our challenge now is to keep up with that technology.
When we talk about precision medicine, one of our goals is to really be able to make patient-specific rehearsals using simulation. So with a 3D printer or with a biomedical engineer that can help us create something, we can actually create the anatomy of a patient, such as a brain tumor or a congenital heart defect. And we can actually allow a surgical team to practice to perform that surgery or that procedure on that specific patient before they actually do it on the real child.
This kind of customized training can help our teams decrease medical errors, operating room times, and even predict challenges. But it starts with support from the community.
When we have a kid who's suffering from heart disease, or we have a kid who's battling cancer, it's easy for the community to come together and help that family, help that team make that patient better. If we don't have innovative training and education, we're not going to build the foundation.
We will be the leader in simulation in the state. Invest in tomorrow and help us lead the way so we can improve the safety and delivery of care for all children.